Good morning. Good morning to all. We are grateful to Mr. Nadda and Dr. Singh and our foreign guests here for this event. This is very special in our own way. Many people want to know what does rare disease means, how it started. I will just give you a very short introduction. World Rare Disease is an annual observance to help raise awareness about rare diseases and the impact of living with rare diseases on patients, families, and caregivers. The celebrations begin February 1st and extends through the entire month, with the final day of February recognizing as a World Rare Disease Day, a day dedicated to improving the lives of all those impacted by rare diseases, a day to educate the world on what it is like to be affected by a rare disease, and a day to inspire the world. 1 in 20 people will live with a rare disease at some point in their life. There is no cure for most of the rare diseases, and many go undiagnosed. Rare Disease Day ensures that we improve the knowledge amongst the public of rare diseases while encouraging the researchers and decision makers to address the needs of those living with these conditions. At the time of IORD inception, the phrase rare diseases or orphan diseases has been most part unknown in India, including published literature. In the last 14, 15 years, with many efforts of IORD and good words of President Dr. Kalam, we came a long way, but rare diseases still not a household phrase. One of the difficulty issues faced by bureaucrats when they wish to write a policy is the lack of data. For example, what is the definition of rare disease? How many people are there with rare diseases? Where they are, it is completely unknown. When such a sticky situation occurs, it is the common practice to borrow the definition from developed countries who have been using definitions of their own based on their extrapolations or approximation or small patient size. Applicability of such definition to our country is unknown. For all the above reasons, the availability of reliable epidemiological data on rare disease is increasingly perceived as a strong and urgent need. This is a very critical piece of information that is missing, and only the policy that is made without knowing anything, probably not very effective. With humble request, sir, we suggest, among many other ideas, to include the rare diseases in the upcoming census survey. We do this survey every 10 years. This is cost effective and probably get the first information you ever wanted it. And next 2 years, it will be coming. Therefore, it is time to get serious about it. Sir, we as patient organization with our limited resources, we are able to represent India as one of the following members of the Rare Diseases International, whose mission is to become voice for global rare diseases population. We presented a unified global voice to the United Nations as NGO committee for rare diseases under the umbrella of UN Congo, and participated in WHO Human Rights Commission conference in Geneva. It is my hope, not only encouraging the patient organization, but also please support their activities at a global level. I would like to bring to your attention another issue that is very important to us, probably may not be for the developing countries, that is prevention of rare diseases. Many rare diseases are genetic disorders, do not have affordable cures. Even at the rate of 100 drugs per year, we take at least a century to get treatment for 7,000 of them. India has already taken steps to prevent monogenic disorders such as sickle cell disease. This program that was initiated in Gujarat 2 decades ago is now showing very positive results by reducing the incidence by 55%. This Gujarat model can be applied to at least in principle, to more than 2,000 monogenic disorders. It is my sincere hope the government takes adequate steps in the prevention, which is a lot less expensive than anything else. Lastly, there are many challenges that patient communities report when engaging with policymakers who are often confronted with allocating scarce resources. We, as patient representatives, have many wants and needs. If not, today, in the near future, we hope give us the opportunity to allow us to partner with policymakers, allow us to share the information that we gathered globally over a decade. Finally, World Rare Disease Day is the perfect time to remind all of us, including the policymakers, that if we provide everyone with affordable health care that includes rare diseases, then you drive up the economy and drive down the inequity and poverty. It is the preeminent answer in the struggle for global health equity. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ramaiah Muthyala, for that wonderful address. And I now have the pleasure of inviting Dr. Namineni Srinivas Garu onto the dais. Honorable Vice President of India, Shri M Venkaiah Naidu Garu, could not be with us. However, he sends us his message.
Namaste. The message of Honorable Vice President of India, Shri Venkaiah Naidu Garu. For Rare Disease Day commemorations being organized by Indian Organization of Rare Diseases at Vigyan Bhavan on 28th February 2018. I am very happy that we are celebrating World Rare Diseases Day 2018 today. Due to unavoidable circumstances, I am not present here interacting with international dignitaries, policymakers, rare diseases patients and their parents, researchers, pharma and biotech industry personnel. I want to congratulate the organizers from the Indian Organization of Rare Diseases, IORD, who are dedicated to raise the awareness of the rare disease among masses, advocate for health policy, promote drug development, and spearhead this event. As you all know, there are more than 7,000 genetic and acquired rare diseases affecting a considerable number of people. This needs attention as well as collaborations of all stakeholders, ministries of health and family welfare, pharmacy, commerce, science and technology, and other ministries. I am told that the government of India is making a consensus document that sets the plan for the national policy on rare diseases, a comprehensive agenda that evaluates the entire rare disease healthcare ecosystem, which would help in providing the orphan drug discovery, development, and delivery of treatments to the rare diseases patients. A foremost thing that is to define the phrase rare diseases, which will help to set the public financial incentives to pharma companies to invest in drug development for rare diseases in India. Basic sciences have discovered and invented many inventions, and those need to be translated into products that reach the patients and public. As the number of rare disease patients is more in India, there would be a tremendous scope for clinical trials for approval of new drugs and betterment of rare patients. India provides major advantage over other developed countries as we can provide patients closer to the clinical trial centers. Prevention of rare diseases is very important to our country as there are drugs available for the diseases and the therapies. However, they are very expensive and are unaffordable and hence do not reach the needy. Prenatal screening centers for the genetic disorders and need for genetic counselors create a new opportunity for new industries. These have already been looked into by ICMR. Providing them infrastructure for the research on the orphan drugs, support of the patients and the patient organizations with the knowledge on rare diseases and collaboration with NGOs in health sector would go a long way in supporting the rare disease ecosystem. I would like to advise all the stakeholders, including the government, to formulate a national health policy at the earliest on the rare diseases, which will be a torchbearer for the rare diseases community in the world. Thank you. Jai Hind.
I just wanted to inform you that our newsletter, IORD newsletter number 3, will be released today by our health minister as a part of this.
Thank you, Dr. Namineni Srinivas Garu, for that wonderful, inspiring message. I'm sure we have a lot of encouragement from Venkaiah Naiduji's message, and it opens up a lot of opportunities for research and for NGOs to also join hands in this effort. Now I have the pleasure of inviting our guest of honor, Dr. Jitendra Singh Ji. Okay. So he's passing his option by. Now I have the pleasure of requesting our Union Minister of Health, Government of India, Shri J.P. Naddaji, to kindly come and give his valuable message.
Dr. Jitendra Singh Ji, our minister and an esteemed colleague in Government of India, Madam Preetip Sudanji, the Secretary of Health, Government of India, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Dr. Seth, Dr. Ramaiah, Dr. Nagaraju, Dr. Arundhan, and leaders of the health sector who have been working very hard and who also give direction to the health sector, the friends from the media, the print media and electronic media, and their friends.